So today we're playing Crash Bandicoot, and let me tell you guys a story about this game. I played it when I was like 4 years old, and it was a lot of fun. So it's cool that they actually released an HD version of the game, and you can play it, and it's super beautiful, and I love the way everything looks, and it's so much fun. I mean, really, you just go around, and then you mess up so often, though. You just die from the dumbest things, and you die, and you die, and you die, and you die, and dying is a lot of fun. It's my favorite aspect of the game. You know, all the death animations for Crash are amazing. I think they're actually pretty cool. And aside from all the death and making it feel like Dark Souls, the game is very fucking fun. I mean, seriously, you just jump and spin, and the stages are pretty, and the lighting is cool, and there's bad guys, and occasionally they do things, but for the most part, enemies aren't really an issue unless you're, like, jumping on a platform and they're blocking the way because they're assholes or something, and then you end up falling and dying, and it pushes you off, and that's the most frustrating thing ever in the fucking world. Why did they think that was a good idea? And then there's times where you just jump, but you don't actually make the jump because the depth perception in Crash 1 is really fucking bad. And that's been a problem since the original version of the game on the PS1. I've always had issues with jumps on this game just because of the depth perception. I definitely think for 2 and 3 they fixed it, but fuck, you die a lot because of depth perception. Holy shit, you just jump and then you miss the jump by like an inch or two, and then you die, and it's right before you get to a checkpoint. Or you think that you jumped over something, but you didn't actually jump over it because you didn't jump high enough. So instead of just tapping X, you hold it to try and jump a little higher, but you end up not making the jump anyways because the game is stupid with its depth perception. And look at all the times you messed up like a dumbass because you didn't get a box or two, even though I'm pretty sure you don't care unless you're getting the platinum, but holy shit, get off my dick. They also let you play as Coco in this one. I thought that was pretty cool, though, that they actually added Coco in as a playable character for Crash 1, because you can play as her in Crash 3 in a couple stages, I think. And you can play as her in Warped is 3. What's the one on the fucking PS2? The one that no one talks about, Wrath of Cortex. There you go. You can play as her there, but now you can play as her in Crash 1. And it's not on every single stage, but it's still cool that they allow you to play as Coco. And it might just be a me thing, but I swear that she jumps a little higher, or she's a little quicker than Crash. I think it might just be a me thing. But holy shit, death perception is your worst enemy. I swear you die so many fucking times from death perception because you just don't make the jump. And then you think you made the jump, and then you get the ugly ass Uka Uka on the fucking game over screen, and he taunts you, and you just die and die and die and die, and it's not fun. Seriously, this game sucks. And that bridge stage is the bane of my fucking existence because you think that you're okay, and then you die and 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 nothing else happens. You just die, 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 die. It's death after death after death, and it is painful. But after suffering death to death perception, I think the game is still pretty okay. You know, it's fun, it's challenging, it's very rewarding when you beat a level after dying so many times, and hell, it looks very gorgeous. So props to Naughty Dog and everybody else for making Crash Bandicoot a cool guy and making him relevant again. I mean, seriously, at least the other games are better. Fuck Crash 1, this game sucks ass.